subject irrigation engineering, chapter irrigation efficiencies, topic water application efficiency. So now let us understand about the water application efficiency. As from the name, I told you that you have to play with words, right? Application. As from the name, it is clear, we have to apply water, right? So let me give an example. Now this water has been supplied to field, right? This was the canal. So this water has been supplied to field. This was V1, this was V2, and we know that V2 is smaller than V1. All these things we have discussed, right? Okay. Now what is that? What is happening is that on this particular field, we have crops. On this field, we have crops. Clear? Now, this is the depth. This is the depth of soil. I am just taking this, you can say, section, right? This is the ground level, right? Okay? Now, I am just taking this particular land. So, what is happening is that when the water will come on the surface of field, right? So, what will happen? It will, you can say, go inside. The water will go inside through the pores, right? Okay, so what is happening is that some water will be retained by soil and some water will percolate due to the gravity, the force of gravity, and it will join the groundwater table. Simple, right? It means that whatever the volume which arrived at the field, not all the volume has been, you can say, has been held by the soil. Some water will join the groundwater table. So I can say that the and this water which has been held by soil is known as capillary water, I told you, right? So I can say that the capillary water will be equal to total water minus gravity water. Simple. Okay, now what is this water application efficiency? So water application efficiency, now whatever water has been held by the soil, again I'm repeating, whatever the water which has been held by soil divided by the initial. So what was the initial? The water which was transferred to this field is known as the water application efficiency. So let me write it here. So water application efficiency, let me use the black marker. So yes, so water application efficiency is eta A, is denoted by eta A. It is equals to water held by soil, volume of H2O means water held by soil divided by total volume of water transferred to the field or total volume of water received by the field. So total volume of water received by field. Or you can also say that the volume of water held by soil up to the root zone, that thing also you can say, by soil up to root zone divided by the total volume of water received by field. And if you want to calculate it in percent, then you have to multiply it with 100, so you will be getting the efficiency in percent also. Okay, so that is what the water application efficiency is. So whatever the volume which has been held by the root zone divided by the initial water which was coming to the field is known as the water application efficiency. It means that water has been applied. Now how much water has been kept by the root zone? So we have to calculate the water application efficiency. Now it's time to solve one numerical based on the water application efficiency in the next lecture. Thank you.